I'm Shamindar Singh. I'm owner of Cane River Lodge, which has been here for the last 27 years outside Panna National Park.
So Panna, can you give us a short introduction of what Panna is all about?
Panna once was a hustling bustling town because the diamond trade happened here. And the forest has deprived the mining because the mining is not allowed in these forest reserves. So it's been a sleepy old town, the population has not really grown. And there's no development work, and it's been stagnated for quite some time.
So what do people do there? How do they make a living? How many people live there? Is it slum areas inside the city, or?
The population is about 70 to 80,000. It's just in the last 15, 20 years, it's just grown by about 10 lakhs. And it has been supported by the government officials, by the salaries they get in. There's a big, huge forest department there. There is NMDC, which is a mining corporation. And they get in the revenue through their salaries. As trading, it's not a great place for trading.
So how is the school situation? Are there enough schools there? Do the kids go to school?
Yes, that's the only way. The schools are there. And that's the only opportunity for them to bring about a career is through education. So they go to schools, if they do well, and that's their license to get out.
You are one of the big supporters of our project here to build up the skate park in Panna. What is the driving force behind this idea? Why are you supporting this?
I liked, when you spoke about this skate park, I liked the idea because it gives an opportunity for the children which are deprived of other benefits to bring about their self from this little, they have something to do apart from the academic, which is the only way where they can reach to the outside world.
So we've actually chosen a place a little bit outside of Panna, not directly in town. What is this place about?
Well, there's not much area which is left. When you are trying to bring about these kind of projects, there is no land left. All of it is very expensive to bring a project like this. So that was the only land which was available, and you had supportive people who liked the idea, and it's not too far. I don't think it's too far because that's the only place where the town is going to grow.